Кейт Депьюри, Associated Press. С вашего позволения,
with
я тоже
задам
вопрос на английском.
I will ask a question in English.
The U.S. wants Russia to do more to persuade North Korea to halt its missile programs. Would Russia support tougher sanctions against North Korea? And do you think that cooperation on North Korea could warm up U.S.-Russia relations, or have you lost hope of mending them under Mr. Trump? Thank you.
Интересные вы ребята.
You're interesting people.
Вы
really.
Не обратили внимания, что ваши
Have you noticed
конгрессмены
that you're congressmen? Your senators, they look so well, so nice, so handsome. They have ties and shirts, and they seem to be smart people, but they put us on the same shelf with North Korea and Iran. And at the same time, they ask the U.S. president to address the issues of North Korea and the Iranian nuclear program together with us. Are you? Are you okay? It just looks weird. It just doesn't make much sense.
Наша политика.
Anyway,
в отличие от политики некоторых
стран, our policy, unlike that of certain other countries, is not nearsighted. We don't look at our immediate goals. We do our best to work with everybody on critical security issues. We don't get offended, we don't act arrogant, we don't hold any grudges, even when some people make certain decisions. As far as North Korea is concerned, we, you know, our position. We don't recognize North Korea as a nuclear state. We think that all the things happening there are counterproductive. I would like to repeat that basically there was an agreement between with North Korea that in 2005 that they will suspend their nuclear program, and they've made certain commitments, and everybody was happy. We all agreed and signed this agreement. Then a few months later, the United States decided to go beyond this agreement. And they froze their assets, their bank accounts of North Korea, and they said that North Korea should do something in addition to this agreement, something that goes beyond that agreement. North Korea then withdrew from this agreement and relaunched its nuclear program. Why did you do that? This agreement was not enough. Why did you sign this agreement if you thought this was not enough? You provoked North Korea to withdraw from this agreement. And then it was even worse. There was Libya and Iraq. I've mentioned this many times. To North Korea, this is the only way of self-preservation. They have to have WMDs and missiles, and now they have a missile that can reach the United States. Apparently. So what good came out of it? We think both sides should stop escalating the situation. So I think we heard from the United States that they would stop military drills. No, they have another military exercise, and North Korea responded by launching another missile. You have to stop at a certain point. You have to stop this from spiraling. This is extremely dangerous, and we told the United States about this. Even if you suppose that the United States launched some kind of strike against North Korea, even if it's conventional weapons, if it's high-precision missiles, where are you going to strike? Does the CIA know specifically which targets they have to hit? No, of course not. North Korea is a closed country. There are things you may know about it and things that you certainly don't know. And just if North Korea launches its missiles, consequences will be catastrophic. Yes, we know that there was an instance when the United States used nuclear weapons. There was that one instance when the U.S. used nuclear weapons against Japan, and even back then I think it was unwarranted. But now this will be extremely, extremely dangerous if they do that with North Korea. Well, we heard a recent statement from Rex Tillerson, and this is really encouraging. I think there has been some shifts with the State Department, maybe with the CIA intelligence services. If we all proceed from common sense, if we all act like this, of course we will cooperate with the United States on all issues, including North Korea. Okay.